Good day, I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus. It has been such a great honor for me, privilege for me to share the word with you, not just on Sundays, but over the past year, also on Tuesdays, since the lockdown and the pandemic started. The whole purpose of me sharing the word for you on Tuesdays was to teach you to pray. Most of the time we spoke about effective prayer, we spoke about the Lord's Prayer, we spoke about fasting and prayer. As a pastor, my responsibility is not to entertain you, and it is not to make you feel good about yourself. My responsibility from God is to teach you the truth of the word, to teach you to practically apply the word of God in your life, to live a successful, effective, and a victorious life. And there are four pillars I want to share with you today that is very powerful, that has changed my life. And then there is also a short dynamic video of just 2 minutes that I'm going to share with you today, also to just implement and confirm what I'm teaching you today. But I want to start off by saying that we are not going to continue with the Tuesday broadcast anymore, but we are going to continue with the English Sunday morning service broadcasts on YouTube. But then I'm starting on Sunday evenings at 8 o'clock on Facebook in Afrikaans. Exactly the same when I'm preaching in the morning, I will be ministering to people in Afrikaans on Facebook. But first, let us get to the word. And I'm reading for you from Acts 2 verse 42. And this is the four pillars. It says, and they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and prayers. Now you may ask of me today, Pastor, why aren't you continuing on Tuesdays? Well, here's the thing. Sunday, I share the word with you. And then I haven't even fully digested the sermon or applied it. The Tuesday's already there with something new. And here is the thing. On Sunday, I'm teaching you the word. And we should not just be hearing the word. We should be doing the word. It is like training, an athlete training without supplements. You know, your muscles are not going to get firm. You need that extra protein within your body for your muscles. So I can't just give you the word. Give you the word is like taking supplements. But if you're not doing it, it's not going to work. Or it's like training hard without supplements. So I can have religious activities, but not having the word of God in my life. That's also not going to work. So we really need to take the word of God and apply it within our lives. Because here is a very powerful statement that Jesus made. And he said, In Matthew 22, the New Living Translation, verse 29, Jesus replied, he said, your mistake is that you don't know the scriptures and you don't know the power of God. He's talking to religious leaders. He says, your mistake, telling a religious leader, imagine you're telling a pastor, your mistake is you don't know the scriptures. And therefore, you also don't know the power of God. And the power of God in your life is in knowing the scriptures and doing the scriptures. Therefore, it says here, first of all, let me read again. And they continued steadfastly. They continued steadfastly. What does that steadfastly? First, what does the continue mean? It means to do the same thing over and over and over again. So this is the basics, the foundation. You want something new. Oh, I need something fresh in my life. Well, Jesus is your new. Jesus is your fresh. You just need to apply these four principles and you will have the fresh and the new within your life, and you will not have to run after this prophet and that outpouring, but you will see the newness of God in your life. So they continued doing the same thing over and over and over again, right? And then it says steadfastly, with the same attitude that they started in the beginning, whether it's raining, whether it's snowing, you do these things, you go to church, you have the same intention, whether you're working hard, whether you're exhausted, like many of the mothers today with homeschooling their kids and still have to work, or many other challenges that people are facing, you're continuing with that same excitement and fervency and determination continuously. You continue fervently and you continue steadfastly, right? In the what? Apostles' doctrine. Now, this is one thing that my spiritual leader taught me, and this changed my life completely. You know what? We all need a pastor in our lives. We all need an apostles' doctrine in our lives. And therefore, you can't just be running from one church to the other. You need to find a pastor that can help you. Why? Because we tend to read the scripture at our level of understanding, right? And you need somebody to lift you up. So if you're depressed, you're going to look for all the depressed scriptures in the Bible. If you need finances, you're just going to look there. Some people has got this promise books. They don't even read the Bible anymore. They just read this promise books. And you need someone that's not going to give you just ice cream. You need someone that's going to give you your fruit and your vegetables and your meat to eat, so that you can grow up in the Word of God and become mature. And I remember when I first spoke to my spiritual leader, the first time I said to him, you know what, I don't understand. There's a lot of things in the church. I'm a pastor, I'm new, and I've got this and this and this questions. And he said to me, you know what, all you do is just follow me. Every conference I have, every meeting I have, you just show up and you're there. You listen, you've got your notes, you've got your notebook, you listen. And this is exactly what I did. I started listening. I went to every conference, to every meeting he had. I had my laptop there. I made sure that not one word is falling to the ground. I made the notes. Because you know what? In university, in school, we believe in the power of repetition. But in church, every week, we want something new. But you can't even get the basics right. So I learned from him. And I want to tell you today, if it wasn't for my spiritual father and mother, who's not running after me, who's not spending time with me the whole time, they've got the ministry, but I am following them. I'm following their word. I'm doing their instructions. And you know what? It has changed my life. And the other day, you know, you get people that says, oh, listen to this minister, listen to that pastor. And I went and I listened to different pastors, and it almost as if it wanted to bring in confusion in my life. And I learned, God has sent an apostle. He sent a pastor for me. There's nothing wrong with the others. They're anointed. They've got very good word. But you know what? Listening to this one, to that one, to that one actually brings confusion. You've got to get one person and say, I'm going to listen to the teachings. Because my dad always said, you know, a stray dog gets lost. And when you go from this one, you don't know what you pick up everywhere. So get one apostle, get one preacher that can speak into your life, that can lift you up to a higher dimension within your life. So it says that continued steadfast. And I want to tell you, I don't miss it. I don't miss a service. I don't miss a teaching that I have. I don't miss anything. I am there always to learn, because we've got so much to learn. Then let me quickly continue with the next one. And I'm going to show you after this recording and this word, I'll share with you the video that is applicable on this, on the Word of God, the effect that it has within our lives. And then it says, secondly, fellowship. Fellowship speaks of, it says, continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and in fellowship. And therefore, it is so important that you get into a life class, into a cell group meeting. You know, some people are friends and you say, oh, this is my best friend. But your best friend, oh, and I can do what I want, I can say what I want. No, that's not a best friend. A best friend comes and says, listen, you can't say that. That's going to destroy your life. You can't wallow here in self-pity. Come on, let's get you out of here. That is a best friend. And therefore, get with your leaders, get with your pastors, get with people that can take you to a new level in your life, that do not leave you in the pit where you are. And this is why we don't have Tuesdays meetings anymore, new sermons, because on Sunday, you take notes of the sermon, you read through the sermons, you work through the sermons. On your cell meeting, you discuss it, you ask questions, and now you ask things, and I've got a whole thing, I'll put it in the comments, yeah, of what effect will being obedient to this word have in my life, or disobedience, and my relationship, what will it have with my relationship with God, myself, with others? What do I need to put off? What I need to put on? How do I apply it? What changes do I need to make to my mindset, my actions, my character, my wife being, my schedule, my lifestyle, my relationship, my wife dealing? What else did I get from this word? Do I need to confess it? Can I claim a promise? Did I find an example to follow? Is there a command I need to obey? In what way did my knowledge increase? What did I learn from God, people, God's plan in my life? So you grow when you are in community with one another. There you pray for one another. There you see the healing of God. There you support one another. So have fellowship with people that even my leader, sometimes I think, you are... I've still got so much to grow. And this is exactly why we need to get in fellowship, in life classes and life groups, so that we can be lifted up and going to a new level within our lives. And then he said also, continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine, in fellowship, in the breaking of bread. This is communion. The blood of Jesus is so important within our lives. And the reason why it's so important within our life is the foundation of all our relationships. It comes and it forgives all our sins. It heals relationship. By the blood of Jesus, we are redeemed from the power of the enemy. By the blood of Jesus, God changes us continually and cleanses us continually from our sin. We have been justified. He sees us as if we have never sinned. We've been sanctified. He's set apart for a purpose. So we need the blood of Jesus to restore for the forgiveness in our life. He restores our hearts, our emotions, our souls. This is why we need the blood of Jesus, because the blood of Jesus was shed from his heart. Therefore, you don't have to have communion just on a Sunday church. You can have it every day at your house. You can have it in your fellowship groups. Wherever you are, when you're struggling, there was a time every half an hour I would have communion and say, Lord, I'm taking victory over this because you have given me the victory. So through the blood of Jesus, by stripes that we are healed, it's through the blood of Jesus that we have purpose, that our hands are blessed and that we can heal people. We can make a change in this world. It's through this blood that curses over our lives are broken and that we can be faithful because of the blood of Gethsemane. We can be faithful, reliable, dependable, trustworthy. Therefore, your identity is linked to the blood of Jesus. This is where our identity is. So continue steadfastly in that, in having that as the foundation, your point of departure from your love. This is why the church had the victory they had, the early church. And then it says lastly, and they continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine, in fellowship, and in breaking of bread and in prayers. And this is why I spend so much time teaching you how to pray and teaching you to focus on God, that if God is in it, it shall be forever. And don't worry about anything, but pray about everything. And how Jesus went early in the morning before they disturbed him and prayed. And our life will be effective if our prayer life is effective. Not to pray doubting and, oh Lord, where are you? And complaining prayers, but to pray prayers of faith that avails much, right? The fervent prayers of the righteous that avails much, that brings forth a lot of power within your life. And therefore, I want to encourage you to continue in this. And then lastly, what I want to bring to you is that, what is our purpose in life? And our purpose, we see God says in John 14 verse 15, if you love me, keep my commandments. What are the commandments? Matthew 22 verse 37 to 41, we read that the commandments are to love God. I'm summing it up in my own two sentences. Love God, love people. Because we've got to love God with all our heart and our neighbors as ourselves. How do we love God? We love God by loving people. How do we love people? We love them by impacting their lives and changing their lives and empowering their lives. And you and I cannot do that by just hearing a little Sunday sermon and then we go off and still living the life we want to live. No, we've got to get into the Word of God. We need to be accurate concerning the Word of God. Doctors need to be accurate, otherwise people die in the operations. And here we come as children of God and we just, ah, it's the Bible, I'll go to church whenever I feel. No, God says in Hebrews 10 verse 25, he says you must go to the prayer meetings or to the gatherings and not neglect it. So we must do the Word according to the Bible. And therefore I want to encourage you, this is why even in our church we've got life class, we've got destiny training, we've got our encounter weekends where we encounter what Jesus did on the cross. We have a reboot weekends, which we talk about your marriage, relationships, love, sex. We talk about all those things to bring in the holiness of God into that, into our parenting, into our communication, into our roles as wives and husbands, in our lives, in our marriage, in lives. So therefore at church we are practical. We teach you these things. In fact, in our teaching every Sunday, I am actually training you to be able to teach others, because this is where the breakthrough and the anointing in your life is going to be. By not just hearing the Word, not just saying, oh, it was a nice little sermon. No, but by taking the notes, going through them, praying the notes, sharing them in your family cell during the week. Have 1 week after dinner, sit around and say, let's just discuss Sunday's Word. How can we as a family apply it? Take it to your workplace. I have heard testimonies of people at work where the troubles that they had, the problems, the issues that they had were lessened because their groups that work together started to have prayer meetings and cell meetings at the work. So you take it there, you take it to your family, you take it to your cell, you take it to your cell members, to the people that you lead to Christ, and you share it with them. And in my own life, the more I share the Word of God, the more I apply it, the more it is practical within my life. And once again, this is what we want to teach you, to be practical. So yes, I want to encourage you, as we share the last 2 minutes that message with you, Be blessed. Go and do this what I'm telling you to do. And you will really grow and grow and grow from grace to grace, from glory to glory. I'm so glad that I can speak into your life. But this word is going to mean nothing for you unless you do it. So I believe that you're going to start doing the word. Thank you for being with me today. God bless you.
By the Center for Bible Engagement, where they pulled 40,000 general population in the U.S. from 8 to 80, and they just wanted to see how we are engaging with Scripture.
Right.
And they discovered something that actually became kind of the profound discovery of the entire study. They weren't even looking for this, and this is kind of became the highlight of the study.
Right.
When we're in the Scripture one time a week, and that could be church on Sunday, that's pastor saying you open your Bible, we hear the message, one time a week had negligible effect on some key areas of your life. So I'm going to spell that out more here in a moment. Two times a week, negligible effect. Now at three times a week, there was a blip on the map, like there was a heartbeat. Something happened, again, a heartbeat.
Okay.
But here was the profound discovery. When we're in the Scripture four times a week, it literally spikes off the chart. You would expect that it'd be one, two, there'd be a gradual incline on the effect and impact that would have in your life, but it was literally one, two, three, four, something radically happens.
Okay, you got my curiosity.
To this extent.
What kind of behavior is being affected?
Feeling lonely drops 30%.
Wow, four times a week in the
four
Bible.
Four times a week in the Bible.
Okay.
Anger issues drop 32%. Bitterness in relationships, marriage, a relationship with your kids, and so on, drops 40%. Alcoholism drops 57%. Feeling spiritually stagnant. You know, if there was one area when I'm talking with people that they'll be honest about is they just feel spiritually stagnant. Ask them the question, how much time are you spending in Scripture? If they're in the Scripture four times a week or more, it drops 60%.
Wow.
Viewing pornography drops 61%.
That's very important.
Now, on a flip positive side, sharing your faith jumps 200%.
Wow.
Because you have a confidence in God's word. And then discipling others jumps 230%.
That's amazing.